Hi everyone, welcome to Hot.News, News, the hottest events digest from all over the Polkadot ecosystem. And of course, we should start from the basement of all the Polkadot universe. Substrate framework was upgraded to version 2.0. It's a big news for all the projects built on Substrate, because now Substrate 2.0 coming with over 70 palettes that makes developers work easier to build custom scalable blockchains interoperable with the Polkadot ecosystem. To know more, join Sub-Zero, the Substrate Developer Community Conference that will be held on the 15th of October. Speakers will include Parity founder Gavin Wood and Jutta Steiner, along with the Parity core developers, as well as developers from Akala, Kilt, Equilibrium, PureStake, LimeChain, Snowfork, Chronicled, and Commonwealth Labs. Seems that is going to be the hottest party of the fall, so don't miss it. Link to the registration is in the comments. A lion's share of views got the news about adding Polkadot and Kusama accounts to an Ethereum name service domain. ENS is decentralized naming for wallets, websites, and so on. That means one name to all users, cryptocurrencies, informant name ETH. Supporting wallets allows senders to use ENS domains instead of long addresses, that is much more convenient and safe. Looks like everyone wants to have their own domain. Hurry up, the coolest names will be taken first. Read how to guide clicking the link below. Bifrost placed its early supporters with new incentive testnet Asgard CC3. 18,000 BNS will be distributed among participants for testing this promising DeFi network. The testnet and the prizes are divided into three parts: 9,000 BNS for validators phase started on 24th of September, 3,000 BNS for EOS cross-chain transfers part started on 30th of September, and 6,000 BNS for VToken redemption test that will start on 10th of October. More than 300 already joined the fund, and there are only 500 validator slots, so come on and take your place among them. How to participate? Read by clicking the link in the comments. Seems that the mainnet season is open. Darwinia and Doc Network announced the mainnet start. Colorful and heterogeneous Darwinia network started from activation of the staking function. Users with the Darwinia's native ring Orcton balance can now participate in validations and staking. Read about it in the guide placed in the comments. Users who haven't ring Orcton for now should wait for stage 3 when two-way cross-chain bridge with Ethereum will be established. Stay tuned to be informed. Doc Mainnet is now live. Doc Network reached the important milestone. This mainnet started on the 30th of September. Initially, Doc launches as a proof of authority network and will migrate to proof of stake during 2021. Proof of authority is an algorithm used with blockchains that delivers comparatively fast transactions through a consensus mechanism based on identity as a stake. It usually runs by the core team of the project. Proof of stake is a type of consensus algorithm by which a cryptocurrency blockchain network aims to achieve distributed consensus. It usually runs by community. According to DocWiki, the POA phase is divided into two phases. First phase will last about 2-4 months with the Association Council full governance. During the second phase, all the changes in the network will be done after voting between councils. Proof of stake stage will begin after proof of authority phase ending. At the same time, with the mainnet, the second proof of stake testnet will begin. Phala Network and Musk Book reached a partnership. Musk is a trading widget powered by Uniswap and CMC. It automatically pops up whenever your mouse hovers on a dollar sign plus ticker, like we usually write in Twitter, dollar sign ETH or dollar sign UNI. Users can now view token price and trade with Uniswap without leaving Twitter. To show the capabilities, MaskBook launched a short demo with Phala network as an example, and should be said, it looks impressive. Sora network performed referendum on the new tokenomics. The referendum passed with a big margin, and main changes concern the migration from the first version of XOR token to the second one, the capping first XOR at 350,000 until the second version launch, and appearing a new staking reward token called CTK. All the changes are complicated, but very interesting and definitely worth studying. Read more in Sora's article, the link is below. Another news is about Polkadot and Kusama parachain auction. Sora network will participate in both and reserve up to 30% of swap tokens from 30 million total supply to reward the community for voting. Plasm Network's second lock drop is ended. There are more than 9,400 participants and more than 137,000 ATH blocked for more than $50 million of US dollars. It's more than 8 times more than first lock drop, and there are 13.6 billion PLM is the total supply. And there are discussions about denomination. That is incredible and unpredictable result, and we congratulate the Plasm team. Meanwhile, some part of the community thinks that the second Plasm lock drop would dilute the value of the early lock droppers, and Plasm CEO Sato Watanabe has the opposite opinion. His point of view you can read in the new Plasm Networks forum. Link is below. And what do you think about this? Do you think that earliest contributors suffer from the second lock drop, or you agree with the Plasms? Please write what you think in the comments. Also, you can check the Plasm network plans to implement scalable smart contracts in new article. Stafi has got a new Telegram bot made by Ribena validators. Bot can track transfers and rewards, fee changes, democracy and treasury events, custom events. You can try it by clicking the link in the comments. Another news about Stafi came jointly with Bluezell. They have announced a partnership. Bluezell will help to support data for Stafi staking contracts such as pledge, redemption, transactions, as well as mapping information between ART tokens and STAC tokens. Perstake, the company developing the Moonbeam smart contract platform, announced the completion of 1.4 million seed round led by Hypersphere Ventures. Other notable participants include Errington CPR Capital, Hashkey, KR1, Bitcoin.com, Exchange, and Do Capital. The funding will be used to accelerate development of the Moonbeam network, a Polkadot parachain focused on interoperability. Moonbeam network also launched its first public testnet, Moonbase Alpha. The first Moonbeam testnet is purely for development purposes, and the nodes are solely operated by PureStake. The team plans to release testnet upgrades in the future that will add additional features, including the ability for external collators to start producing blocks or the network. More details are available on the Moonbeam documentation website, the link you can find under the video. That's all with the news today, but don't leave. Check out our next blog, Dot Features. Meet the best mobile applications for Polkadot ecosystem. So now we are talking about mobile applications for the Polkadot ecosystem. We can divide it for two main parts: the wallets that provide the ability to hold and earn commission for staking, and the second group is the applications that provide the special features of Polkadot Life: staking, governance, voting, treasury. Today we will talk about the second group and additionally about Parity Signer. It is not a wallet actually, details will follow. Here is one of the best full functional mobile applications, Polka Wallet. This is not just a wallet, this is a full functional application. It provides cross-chain asset management, convenient staking, and governance. The private key is self-owned by users. Polkawallet specializes only in the Polkadot ecosystem at its great. It gives a visually attractive experience and it's open source and created by the community members. What Polkawallet can do? Cross-chain asset management. Manage Relay chain and Parachain assets anywhere, anytime. Initiative staking options. Everything about staking is under control. Convenient governance. Never miss an opportunity to participate in governance. Interchain communications. Cross-chain asset transfer is just a part of functionality. But just remember, mobile wallets are not nearly as secure as desktop or hardware wallets. So we definitely do not recommend you storing a significant amount of tokens in your phone. Polka Wallet, which can be installed from Google Play and App Store. After installing, click on Create Account. The process is basically the same as for the web version. We fill their username and the password and keep the seed in the safe place. Now let's look at the nomination in the Polka Wallet. First, you need to select Polkadot as the network to which the application will connect. Then go to the staking section and click on Bond Funds. Here we have the same settings as in Polkadot.js, so we just select the number of tokens it nominates and confirm the transaction. In the next step, you will have to do a sign and submit again. Enter the password for your wallet and the nomination will be waiting to be processed. So the Polka Wallet is almost full functional application that can be used instead of desktop and application. Now we have a second one, ImToken. Let's see what it can offer the users. This wallet is an application that conveniently saves and transfers DOT and at the same time can be used for staking and voting and use applications on the Polkadot network via the wallet. Let's create new Polkadot and Kusama accounts and backup via mnemonic phase. Press Add Wallet, choose KCM or DOT, add the name and password, save the mnemonic phase to paper, no use screenshot, you got your wallet. To send and receive KCM and DOT, you act like with a normal desktop wallet. You can check your transaction history and portfolio prices. Let's see how to stake bond and unbond KCM and DOT. In ImToken wallet, we'll also have the same settings as in Polkadot.js, so we just select the number of tokens to nominate and confirm the transaction. In the next step, all you have to do is sign and submit, enter the password for your wallet, and the nomination will be waiting to be processed. It needs some time to proceed, so be patient. You can be part of the network by participating in Polkadot and Kusama governance and voting. Vote on proposals and vote for council members and treasury. Press vote, choose the referenda, check the info about the referenda and press vote to participate. You can also see the info about governance and the voting process of council members. So we like ImToken. We see that it's made by professional team with attention to details, but Polka Wallet is more concentrated on the ecosystem. That's why we like it more. And the next application is something you probably never used before. It's a cold wallet by Parity, a cold but cool feature that few people know about, and we reveal it to you. Parity Signer is not actually a wallet or a full functional application. It just converts your old smartphone to private keys keeper for Polkadot and Ethereum ecosystem. It's a great thing, just see how easy it's working. Download your Parity Signer from App Store or Google Play. Now you can turn your smartphone into hardware wallet. With Parity Signer, you keep your private keys secure and sign transactions easily. You also can use it as a hardware wallet for Ethereum and Ethereum-like blockchains. All data is transmitted over via only QR codes. Download, go offline and create your keys. Start by taking your old smartphone, restoring it to the factory settings, then turn off all Wi-Fi and Bluetooth by going into airplane mode once and for all. Press Add with QR code. Show the QR code from the signer to add the account. Don't forget to allow the camera on your desktop. Let's see how to send some funds from the account that is protected by signer. Press Send, choose the address to send, sign with QR code. The system generates the QR code shown it to signer. Then scan the QR code provided by Parity Signer to release your transaction to the blockchain and send your funds. Transaction complete. That's all. Very convenient and safe. Your private keys stay on your offline smartphones. Never confuse which network you are using. Those your favorite mobile applications. And the next release will call the 3 best desktop applications that we like the most. Thanks for watching. Leave your comments and tell us what you would like to be reviewed in the next issues. Bye-bye.